Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, and today we're going to do some painting. Today we're going to do a new technique of painting, which I call submerged painting. So in this we're basically using watercolors or any colors, and in this we have to first make the whole thing wet. I'm painting on a butterfly. We have to make the whole thing dark first. It gives a different texture to your paint. And yeah, I dampened it out and now let's start painting. I'll do some dabs of different color and then I'll show you the painting color. So, you also have to keep this paint really buffy so that the water spreads. In this, there are different techniques about how often you use the paint and how much you want it to spread. All we have to do in this is keep the face damp and the paint still. So, this is how we want it to be. We want it to be clean. Oh, excuse me. So what happens is here, and this is that the paint starts spreading. We have here the sweeper. Also, if you want it, you make it easy enough, you can actually brush it on your fingers to dry out the paint. Of course, it's really messy. So this water is colored, but it's still not showing. When you have more water around the color, you have to put it in completely the color. Thank you. Well, I need to do that with my account. On the other hand, if you do the color less, it won't spread much. And if you do it, it is clean, but it is also useful. Here I'm doing random painting. You can of course make so many things. I'll show you some that I put seriously at the end of the video. Now this one won't get as much as the other. Who are the lot of water and the two spreads like this? I think a lot of them take the submerged shape and it will actually start spreading a lot right there and kind of cloud in the lens, so that's really cool. You can try that yourself. I also did that on something. Now you can write me to listen. Or down the color. You don't want it in a single minute. By the way, I think you can do really cool effects if you're using the garlic. But since I use my garlic on cameras, I just... Yeah, I don't do it like that. Oh. If you do this to the garlic, the things in the comments and the ground. Red. Oh, look at this. I just found out a trick. You do two colors on the canvas, but you know, just to accident, you can just put the green over there and the first person, then I just do it that way. Okay, so that's. So now the. Yeah, that's one big disadvantage of this one, that it takes really long to dry. But until then, you can shift it and dry it onto something like this board, maybe, if it's not completely submerged in it. But if you want it to spread more, you have to put more water and keep it on. So, and it's really cool. I do like it. Yeah, I can just do that one time. And this one is completely disaster, so I use the bottom side of this. And this one I also added in the little bit. And yeah, there are many more I added. For example, there's also another style of this. I kept the chair straight up. You can't see the dots because I've cut it a little bit more after that. So you can see where I use more colors for more water, the colors more still up. Where I use much less water and there's not much in the dollars, but so yeah, I think you should use a lot of water on this one. Unless you want it to be straight. So as you can see, there's a big difference. For example, this is non-existent. This is submerged. The texture is different and the styles are also different. So yeah, that's it for my own technique of painting on it. I hope you enjoyed watching it and I hope you enjoy your winter holidays. Bye!